a trip by university with all bets to succeed in life. So I charge you to go out there and bring your book. Sign his evidence, the same of the very TV. That's what I'm telling you. The best of technology.
Chairman of the Government Council, Professor Femi Odekunle, to deliver his address to the convocation.
Federal Republic of Nigeria, His Excellency Muhammadu Buhari, this year, ably represented by Professor Esu Abdullahi, former Vice Chancellor of ABU Zaria. His Excellency, the Governor of Nigeria, Alhaji Abubakar Sani Bello, the Honorable Minister of Education, members of the National Assembly are present, members of the Federal Executive Council are present, members of the Niger State House of Assembly are present, members of the Niger State Executive Council are present, the Executive Secretary, National Embassy Commission, the Executive Secretary, Chairperson, Your Royal Highnesses, the Chairman, the Chief Press, the Emir of Minna, members of Senate of this university, and the entire staff of the Federal Embassy of the Minna. Prayers and guidance, graduates of this great university, gentlemen of the press, my specially invited friends, ladies and gentlemen, and everybody here present. It is a great pleasure that I stand here to address this important gathering at the 35th final day of the 27th Convocation ceremony of the leading specialized university of science in Nigeria. And when I talk about the leading specialized university, I'm talking about the world of only Federal University of Technology Minna. I'm particularly happy to get the management, staff and students of the university, including meeting all our members and their friends on the successful completion of their programs. All of you do well aware of my prayers, my voice will see me through and will be well. Stressful. All of us, for the greater better, the celebrated as graduates. I therefore salute and commend you for serving as the graduating recipients of the degrees you have earned and which you should be conferred upon you. I also commend your parents and guidance on this way of joy as they reap the fruits of their life's investments. Now, as I have been conferred with different degrees, as well as kinds of degrees and diplomas that indicate your academic levels, I implore you not to see these academic outcomes as the end of your life or as ends on your own. You must consider the degree today only as work in progress, because there is still a lot to be achieved. There are vast opportunities out there inside and outside Nigeria that require your creative thinking and your enterprising spirit. It is my belief that this university has prepared you to meet the challenges ahead. Please do not let us down. But most importantly, do not let yourself down. Yeah, I must acknowledge and know the governors who will be receiving prizes for distinguishing themselves in their studies. And simultaneously, I urge the others who are not winning prizes here today to admit that they still have lots of opportunities ahead, through which they too can also distinguish themselves in their various endeavors. And dear brothers, as you lead this university and go for various pursuits, always remember to conduct yourselves as worthy ambassadors of this number one specialized university in Nigeria. I'm saying this because the ranking of the university, the ranking of this university as first among equals, comes with a high expectation that you should distinguish yourselves wherever you may be and whatever you are doing. In this regard, I will remember in all you do that one major cause of the social, political, and economic challenges that has translated into gross youth unemployment in our country is the true problem of indiscipline and corruption. Both indiscipline and corruption sabotage the government, period. It is therefore imperative for me to admonish you to resist all temptations to manifest indiscipline or indulge in corrupt practices in the leaders of your generation and the good of the fatherland now and for the future. At this juncture, I want to state loud and clear that this university is one that we in the Government Council are very proud to be associated with. Why are we proud to be associated with this university? It is national and cosmopolitan in staff and student composition, as it has always over the years been a place where all Nigerians can feel at home. Additionally, it is peaceful. The environment is serene and the atmosphere is secure. everyone will clap. Therefore, we are not only thankful to President Buhari and the Honorable Minister of Education for appointing us and giving us the opportunity in the first place, but we are additionally grateful because they have sent us to this particular university. We are making our mission, digital counselor, to improve and enhance these every attributes of this university. That is, we do not need to remember the university as a vision and a mission that are both enviable. So all we have to do is to improve and enhance on the vision, the mission, and other attributes. In line with this mission, I'm happy to report that the council recently conducted, as you must have heard from the chancellor's speech, the exercise of selecting a new chancellor for the university. And the council discharged the responsibility with observable transparency, observable fairness, and utmost credibility in the acclaim of all parties, including the candidates who will be elected. To the glory of God Almighty, we have been deserving and prophecy by Samson. I welcome this opportunity to once again assure all stakeholders that the Deputy Council, under my honorable leadership, shall continue to be guided by extant rules and regulations of the university, by due process, and by common sense in overseeing the affairs of the institution. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I must acknowledge the cooperation and hospitality of this community of this university. Starting from Sunoga to Nuno to Vida and Amova, we thank the host community. I thank His Excellency, Governor Patterson Obello. I thank former leaders of our country who are in this state, General Ibrahim Babatoro Bangida and General Abusalamu Abaka, as well as our royal fathers for their work and for treating this university as their own. I also like to thank my colleagues on the University Council for their support in keeping the university on the path of quality, accountability, and due process. Evening, I commend the entire management, senate, and staff of the university for their dedication to duty. I wish to express my appreciation for the preparation of the staff members, especially, particularly, academic staff members of the university also, as well as that of the student union, for their school level of the institution and for the peace on our campuses. And finally, and very importantly, I thank the immediate former chancellor, Dr. Musbah Akoji, for his committed management of the university during his tenure. And I also thank I also want to thank our brand new renowned Vice Chancellor, Professor Abdullah Dala, for promising, for having a promising takeover of the university's collective church. Once again, honorable visitor, Chancellor, I commend the graduates, their parents, and relations. I wish you success in what I will do for your own good and for the good of this country. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Government Council of this university, I thank you very much for being with us today. I wish you safe journey back to your respective destinations. Thank you very much.
Chancellor, sir, I now have the honor to call upon the Vice Chancellor, Professor Abdullah Ibala, to deliver his address.
The visitor of the university and president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, His Excellency President Muhammadu Buhari, GCFR, represented today by Professor Shehu Abdullahi, the Governor of Niger State, Alhaji Abubakar Sani Bello, represented this morning by the Speaker of Niger State House of Assembly, Honorable Marapa, members of the National Assembly, members of the Federal Executive Council here present, members of the Niger State House of Assembly, members of the Niger State Executive Council here present, His Royal Highness Alhaji Dr. Umaru Farouk Bahago and your other Royal Highnesses, the Executive Secretary of the Tertiary Education Trust Fund, Dr. Abdullahi Bapa, members, the Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology, Minna, His Eminence AZ Dr. Ebere Chidi, members of the Governing Council of the Federal University of Technology, Minna, visiting vice chancellors and heads of other tertiary institutions here today, former vice chancellors of the Federal University of Technology, Minna, here represented by the Foundation Vice Chancellor, Professor Ndagi, and my immediate predecessor, Professor Akanji, principal officers of the university, the representative of the Chief of Defense Staff, Air Vice Marshal Oje Osaho, DG Defense Research and Development, representative of the Chief of Naval Staff, Rear Admiral D.E. Ebe-Emo, representative of the Chief of Air Staff, Air Vice Marshal E.D. Amin, the Assistant Co-Marshal, Zobi U, Ogaga Ogene, who is the Zonal Commanding Officer, Zone RS7 Headquarters, the Director, Department of State Service, T.T. Kappa, the Deputy Commissioner, DCP, Adamu Usman, representing Commissioner of Police, the Sector Commander, Federal Safety Commissioner, Yusuf Garba, the representative of the Nigerian Security and Civil Defense Corps, Niger Command, GA, Denga Magaji, DCC, members of Senate of the Federal University of Technology, Minna, distinguished guests, staff, students, parents and graduates, members of the press, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I want to start, in the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, the Omnipotent, and the Supreme Bestower and Solver. I thank Allah for making this day a reality, for granting safe passage to all our invitees and graduates, and for enabling all of our activities to be so far conducted safely and successfully. I welcome the visitor to the University, the President and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, His Excellency Muhammadu Buhari, GCFR, represented this morning. It is also a great pleasure that I welcome the Executive Governor of Niger State, Alhaji Abubakar Sani Bello, also represented. I especially welcome the Executive Secretary, Tertiary Education Trust Fund, Dr. Abdullahi Bapa. We are also highly honored by the distinguished presence of our Royal Fathers, members of the National and State Legislature, members of National and State Judiciary, visiting Vice Chancellors and heads of other institutions, my predecessors, former Vice Chancellors of the Federal University of Technology, Minna, members of the University alumni, members of the press, parents, guardians, and graduates. Although they are our host today, our appreciation would be incomplete without acknowledging and appreciating the presence of the Chancellor, His Eminence, AZ Dr. Eberechi MD, as well as members of the Council, ably led by the Chairman and Pro-Chancellor, Professor Femi Odekunle. These and other distinguished guests here present, I welcome you all. Your presence is a testimony to your support and confidence in the University, and has no doubt added to the color and glamour of today's occasion. As I had earlier observed during the press briefing, which was the precursor to this event, today's ceremony is unique and particularly significant in several respects. It will be the first under my watch as the Vice Chancellor of the University. I assumed office on the 3rd of December 2017, following the completion of the tenure of my predecessor, Professor Musba Adeomu Akanji. The convocation is also the first since the present government council was appointed by the visitor of the university. The new council has an eminent professor of sociology and criminology, Professor Femi Odekunle, as his co-chancellor and chairman. Professor Odekunle comes with a vast wealth of experience from the academia, governmental and non-governmental background. The university is therefore honored to have him as the co-chancellor for the next 4 years. This year's convocation will be the last for Mrs. Victoria Nkolo as the registrar of the university. She has in the last 5.5 years served the university diligently and meritoriously, and we shall remain ever grateful to her for her selfless service and the numerous innovations she has introduced to governance of the university. The university is 35 years old today, following its establishment on 1st February 1983. For the second year running, and in line with global best practices, the university will be holding the convocation ceremony on the 1st of February, which marks the university's Founders Day. Given these unique circumstances around this year's event, the university has every reason to celebrate and to thank God for this providence. Graduating students, this year's convocation ceremony is for the 2016-2017 academic session, and we shall be graduating a total number of 3,741 students. Of this number, 3,096 will receive first degrees, while 426 will be awarded master's degrees. 46 others will bag PhDs, while another 173 will be awarded postgraduate diplomas. Out of those graduating with first degrees, 62 attend first class, 1,006 are in the second class upper division, 1,526 are in the second class lower division, while 468 are in the third class, with 34 having passed degrees. The graduates are from the schools of agriculture and agricultural technology, environmental technology, engineering and engineering technology, entrepreneurship and management technology, information and communication technology, life sciences, physical sciences, science and technology education, and two of our affiliate institutions, the Federal College of Education Technical Apoka and Kaduna Polytechnic. In line with our tradition, the original certificates of graduates will be ready for collection immediately after this convocation. Achievements within the last 1 year. The number of graduating students with first class honors degrees this year accounts for 0.02% of the total number of graduates, but this is better than the 0.01% obtained during the previous year. Also, the 0.15% and 0.01% of third class and past degrees produced this year are lower than the 0.2 and 0.03 respectively for the last session. Clearly, there has been a tremendous improvement by this set over that of last year. This is consistent with the upward swing that the university has been witnessing in recent years. True to the university's vision of being a world-class and enduring student university, the Federal University of Technology, University Minna, is currently placed between 5th and 7th among Nigerian universities by most of the international web rankings. It is placed first among the specialized universities in Nigeria and also placed between 45th and 70th in Africa out of the over 1,500 universities in the continent. These successes came about as a result of our painstaking and unwavering commitment to good governance and global best practices. The university is unrelenting in its responsibility for the welfare of staff and students. Staff morale is kept high by ensuring that salaries, allowances, promotion, and staff development are given as and when due. Except for staff undergoing evaluation for professorial promotion, the Federal University of Technology Minna does not have any backlog of staff promotion. Staff are also provided with the conducive environment and the requisite tools as well as needed facilities within our limited resources for them to effectively discharge their responsibilities. The Directorate of Quality Assurance and Productivity and the Servicom unit of the university have been unrelenting in the pursuit of excellence and effective service delivery. The two units monitor performance and conduct of staff, and their efforts have led efficiency, effectiveness, unwavering commitment, steadfastness, and sacrifice the watchwords of most of our staff. Both staff and students of the university have continued to blaze trail in the area of research and development. As a testimony to our research needs and accomplishments, an exhibition has been going on for the past 2 days as part of activities lined up for the 27th Convocation and 35th Founders Day. Within the past year, the university participated, getting lots of accolades in the process, in the Nigerian Annual Research and Innovation Summit, the Federal Institute of Science and Technology Expo 2017, and the West African Research and Innovation Management Workshop. The university has also continued to forge collaborations with other institutions and organizations, both within and outside the country, the several memoranda of understanding signed. This includes partnerships with the Namibia University of Science and Technology, which also involved Rennes University, Germany, making it a tripartite collaboration, the Center for Geodesy and Geodynamics, Togo, in the area of research and manpower development in geophysics and geotechnical operations, the Nigerian Air Force and Sussex Consultancy Limited in the area of mechatronics research and capacity building, the Federal Polytechnic Diga and Federal Polytechnic Ofa for degree programs in selected areas of engineering and environmental studies. It is worthy of note that as part of our collaboration efforts, the third batch of students undergoing their master's degree in climate change and adapted land use under WASCAL program, sponsored by the Federal Ministry of Education and Research Germany, will be rounding off their program with the university in March 2018. These students from 9 West African countries comprising Benin Republic, Ghana, Mali, Burkina Faso, Cote d'Ivoire, the Gambia, Niger Republic, Nigeria and Togo have been hosted by our university since June 2016 while undergoing a vigorous program on climate change and adapted land use. Giant strides have also been made in physical structures. Earlier this morning, the Executive Secretary of TECFON, Dr. Abnai Bafa, commissioned the newly completed School of Agriculture and Agricultural Technology Complex Phase 2. This building will go a long way in improving the office, classroom and laboratory space in the school. Additional projects funded by the TECFON that is at stage of completion is the School of Engineering and Engineering Technology Phase 2 building. We appreciate the profound support we've been enjoying from TECFON in enhancing the landscape of our campus through funding of very critical projects. Indeed, in the words of my immediate predecessor, Professor Emi Akanji, public higher institutions in Nigeria would have gone into oblivion without TECFON. Let me put it on record that all of the recent successes recorded by the university are largely due to the indefatigable and purposeful leadership of the immediate past Vice Chancellor, Professor Musbao Adeomi Akande. We thank him. The university is grateful for the monumental contributions he has made to the growth and development of the university. In spite of our limited resources, the university has been vigorously engaged in community services, which forms one of our core mandates. Within the last year, the university rehabilitated a block of 3 classrooms for the Gideon Kwano Primary School. We've also helped in securing and transforming a block of 3 rooms into a police outpost for the Gideon Kwano community. The University Information and Telecommunications Service Unit also organized a 1-week intensive training in basic computing for 100 secondary school students drawn from different parts of the Niger Emirate. It is currently conducting a similar training for 400 students drawn from 8 secondary schools within the Minna metropolis. Outlook for the future. In spite of the many successes and developmental strides achieved by the university, there still remain numerous challenges. We are currently working towards accessing funds from both TECFON and the Presidential Needs Assessment for the construction of offices, classrooms, lecture theatres and complexes to enable the relocation of the School of Life Sciences and the School of Physical Sciences from the Boso campus to the main campus. The university is 35 years old today, as earlier observed, yet we have less than 3,000 bed spaces to cater for the over 18,000 students of the university. Our desire is to accommodate at least 75% of this population on campus. We are currently in active consultation with a number of private investors in order to provide hostel accommodation on a public-private partnership basis. Nonetheless, we would like to call on funding agencies, especially tech funds, to give us special consideration by providing some funds for hostel development. We are also appealing to friends of the university, philanthropists, and members of the university alumni to also rise up to the occasion and make their contribution to this effect. Cognizant of the inadequate water availability at the Gilompano campus, the university initiated the construction of an F-dam, which is at the early stages of construction under the Presidential Risk Assessment Fund. However, even after the completion of the dam, the university needs to secure additional funds for the construction of a water treatment plant and a pipeline to transport the water from the dam to the treatment plant. You will agree with me that these are formidable challenges that need concerted efforts from all stakeholders to surmount. We, on our part, are ready to partner with all and committed to all efforts at meeting these challenges. I congratulate the graduates and their parents and guardians. The university has not only given you the best of training in your various fields of specialization, but has also provided you with opportunities for acquiring a range of extracurricular skills and for self-actualization. I enjoin you to be good ambassadors of the university. You should have the self-belief and confidence to go out and conquer the world, not with arms or weapons, but by deploying the limitless power of the human brain and the never say die attitude of the human spirit. Those of our graduates that set forth before you have been attracting accolades and good ratings for the university. Yours should therefore not be different. You should also develop the habit of giving back to the university, your alma mater, no matter how little you may have. The Leave a Legacy project of the university, to which you have made some financial contribution, is meant to trigger and sustain your sense of obligation to your alma mater. As from today, you will formally cease to be students and transit to become alumni. As holders of certificates from FUTMINNA, you now have an umbilical cord that ties you to the university for life. Never forget your roots. I congratulate you once again, and may God be with you all. Mr. Bisto, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for your attention. Thank you very much.
Persons whose names are listed have fulfilled the requirements of the statutes and regulations of the university and have been found worthy both in character and in learning to be awarded the degrees of their various schools. I therefore call upon the deans of the various schools to present their graduates. Starting with the Dean School of Agriculture and Agricultural Technology in the person of Professor Ruben Kolo.
Will the graduating students in the School of Agriculture and Agricultural Technology please stand? Honorable Chancellor, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology examinations and have been found worthy both in character and in learning. to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Agricultural Technology of the Federal University of Technology, Minna.
Students, I want you all as several the degree of Bachelor of Agricultural Technology of the Federal University of Technology, Minna. Congratulations.
The graduates to raise their caps, wear them, and place the tassel of the caps to the left. And please be seated.
Technology, Professor Oladiran Kamadin Abubakar to present his graduate.
We are graduating students in the School of Engineering and Engineering Technology. I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I thank you, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Engineering degree examination and have been found worthy, both in character and learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Engineering for the Federal University of Technology, Minna. The girl should please do that.
By the authority of Senate, I award you all as servants the degree of Bachelor of Engineering of Federal University of Technology. Congratulations.
Will you please raise your cap, wear it, and turn the tassel to the left. Congratulations.
And Management Technology, Professor Salau Sadiku, to present his graduate.
Will the graduating students in the School of Entrepreneurship and Management Technology please stand and remain standing? Honorable Chancellor, sir, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably attend, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology degree examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology.
Chancellor.
by the authority of the Senate, award you all seven the degree of Bachelor of Technology, of Federal University of Technology. Congratulations.
The graduates, please, you can now raise your caps, wear them, and place the tassels of the caps to the left. Congratulations.
Miss, we just want to bring to your attention that this event is being streamed live all over the world. And you can go to our log on to www.futmina.infounit.com.ng. Chancellor, sir, I now call on the Dean, School of Environmental Technology, Professor Asimil Jinaz, to present his graduates. Professor Jinaz.
Will the graduating students of the School of Environmental Technology please stand and remain standing? Honorable Chancellor, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand closing, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology degree examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Technology, Federal University of Technology, Minna. Graduate, please remove your caps. By the authority of the Senate, the degree of Bachelor of Technology of Federal University of Technology, Niger. Congratulations. Dear graduates, please raise your cap, wear them, and place the tassel to the left. Please be seated.
Chancellor, sir, I now call on the Dean, School of Life Sciences, Professor O.A. Fanusi, to present his graduates.
Will the graduating students from the School of Life Sciences please stand? Honorable Chancellor, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand closing, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology degree examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded a degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology in Minna. Graduates, remove your caps.
By the authority of the Senate, I award you, Honorable Chancellor, the degree of Bachelor of Technology of Federal University of Technology, congratulations.
Graduates, you have to raise your caps, wear them, place the tassel of the cap to the left, and please be seated.
Chancellor, sir. I now call on the Dean, School of Information and Communication Technology, Professor Nicholas Walker, to present his graduate.
We graduate with the graduating students in the School of Information and Communication Technology, please stand. Honorable Chancellor, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology degree examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, Minna. Graduates, will you remove your caps?
By the authority of the Senate, I want you all severally the degree of Bachelor of Technology of Federal University of Technology, Minna. Congratulations.
Graduates, raise your caps, wear them, and place the tassels of the cap to the left. And please be seated.
Will the graduating students in the School of Physical Sciences please stand? Honorable Chancellor, sir, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology degree examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology in Minna. The graduates, please remove your caps. The graduates, please raise your caps, wear them, and place the tassels of the caps to the left. Please be seated.
Chancellor, sir, I now call on the Dean, School of Science and Technology Education, Professor Bernard Asumbe, to present his guidance.
Will the graduating students in the School of Science and Technology Education please stand. Honorable Chancellor, sir, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, from whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor
Bachelor of Technology degree examinations, and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, Minna. The graduates, will you please remove your caps? Of the car to the left. Please sit down. Thank you, sir.
Honorable Chancellor, sir, the persons who will be presented to you have fulfilled the requirements of the statutes and regulations of the Federal University of Technology, Minna, and they have been found worthy, both in character and learning, to be conferred with the postgraduate diplomas of the Federal University of Technology, Minna. I now call on the Dean of the Postgraduate School to present recipients of the postgraduate diplomas, Professor NGM Kolo.
Will the recipients of postgraduate diplomas please stand? Honorable Chancellor, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed the postgraduate diplomas and examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to receive the postgraduate diplomas of the Federal University of Technology, Minna.
By the authority vested on me in your council, of the Federal University of Technology, Minna. Congratulations.
Will the graduates please raise their caps, wear them, and place tassels to the cap of the caps to the left. Please be seated.
Honorable Chancellor, sir, the persons who will be presented to you have fulfilled the requirements of the statutes and regulations of the Federal University of Technology, Minna, and have been found worthy, both in character and learning, to confer with the Master of Technology and Master of Engineering of the Federal University of Technology, Minna. I now call on the Dean of the Postgraduate School, Professor NGM Kolo, to present the recipients.
Graduating students for the degrees of Master of Technology and Master of Engineering, please stand. Honorable Chancellor, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed the Master of Technology and Master of Technology Engineering and are found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degrees of Master of Technology and Engineering of Federal University of Technology, Minna. Raise their cards, wear them, and play the tassels on the cards to the left. Please be seated.
Of the status and regulations of the Federal University of Technology, Minna, and have been found worthy, both in character and learning, to be conferred with the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy of the Federal University of Technology, Minna. And I call on the Dean of the Postgraduate School, Professor A.J. Kolo, to present the recipient.
For the graduating students, for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, please stand. Honorable Chancellor, sir, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed a Doctor of Philosophy and found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded a degree of Doctor of Philosophy of Federal University of Technology, Minna.
By the authority vested on me as counsel, I love you all. The degrees of Doctor of Philosophy of Federal University of Technology, congratulations.
Graduates, please raise your cards, wear them, and play the tassels on the cards to the left. I invite you to please come to the podium. We'll have a handshake with the Chancellor of the University. Of the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in the Department of Animal Production, Ibrahim Hadiza. Department of Crop Production, Dogara Dan Baba. To please come forward to have a handshake. Mohammed Iman Raba. Shaba Solomon Jiri, Tolonse Kende Dele. Please come forward to have a handshake with the Chancellor. School of Engineering and Engineering Technology, Baba Aliu Haruna. Yusuf Adeyika Sikiru. Please come forward to have a handshake with the Chancellor for the Department of Civil Engineering, Alhaji Bala Ngwafo Cyril Nelson. From the Department of Communication Engineering, please come forward to have a handshake with the Chancellor, Bello Salal Habib. Inshelia Zaka Audu. From School of Environmental Technology, Department of Architecture, Abdurrahman Mukaila El Hussein. Ebon Samuel Okon. From Department of Urban and Regional Planning, Sani Lekan Mohammed. From School of Information and Communication Technology, please come forward to have a handshake with the Chancellor of the University, Okeke Georgina Nkolika. Department of Cyber Security, Ojemi Joseph Adebayo. From School of Life Sciences, Abdurrasheed Adeleke Tawakatu. Olibiota Florence Inje. Okeke Omorumike Ebele. Department of Biological Sciences, Bello Ismaila Mohammed. Mohammed Habiba Mayukudi. Ukubike Azubike Christian. From School of Physical Sciences, your place invited to come forward to have a handshake with the Chancellor, Musa Mwende. Department of Mathematics and Statistics, Abubakar Abdullahi Mwachi. Ashezwa Timothy Tafa. Tejani Ahmad Asabe. Obi Boniface Unalu. Chado Umar Doko. Adamu Lawa. Yusuf Abdul Hakim. Oyewola David Otoluwa. Department of Physics, Emeterio Moses Eterigo Azuka. Jimo Muftaru Owolabi. Moses Abiodun Steven. Eche Junior Orufe Oforu. Igwe Kingsley Chidoze. From School of Science and Technology Education, please are invited forward to have a handshake. Department of Industrial and Technology Education, Abdulkadri Muhammad. Saba Chayam Moses. Kazeli Sekiulani Adewole. Ibrahim Dauda. Ibrahim Uma Aliu. Muhammad Adiza Asabe. Abdul Bello Kagara. Muhammad Aminu Muhammad. Karim Wahab Bamidele. Department of Science Education, Hosseini Ahmadu.
Following and those who for good reasons are unavoidably absent and for whom I stand closing, who have distinguished themselves by winning special prizes in their respective fields of study during the 2016-2017 session. Receiving Professor Femi Odekunle's prize for the best of our all graduating students in the Department of Cybersecurity Science. And this prize was endowed by Professor Femi Odekunle, the chairman of the Governing Council. The recipient is Onoja Cristiano Ojeche Nemi, with CGPA of 4.55, first class, from the Department of Cybersecurity. We have Professor Rufai Ahmed Al-Khalid's prize for the overall best graduating BTS student. This prize was endowed by the immediate past chairman of the Governing Council, Professor Rufai Ahmed. And the recipient is Okeke Joy Chidimma, with CGPA of 4.77, first class from the Department of Computer Science. The second recipient is for Professor Abdullah Ibala's prize for the best graduating student in the Department of Soil Science and Land Management. And the prize was endowed by Professor Abdullah Ibala. The recipient is Bolariwa Tunde Sahid, with CGPA of 4.73, first class. Professor Musbaum Adeomiakon this prize for the overall best graduating student of the university, endowed by the middle class vice chancellor, Professor Musbaum Adeomi. The recipient is Ngozi Chiku Bright Obochiku, with CGPA of 4.81, first class, from the Department of Chemical Engineering. The prize is endowed by Mrs. Victoria Nolopolo, and it's for the best of our graduating female student of the university. And she is Okeke Joy Chidimma. We also have Pasadi Kufache's Equus Prize for the best graduating student in the Department of Water Resources, Aquaculture and Fishery Technology, endowed by Professor S.O. Sadiku. And the award winner is Ogun Nande Ifenwa, with CGPA of 4.35, second class offer. The next is Amudas Asunke Blessed Ajala's prize for the best graduating student in the Department of Animal Production, endowed by Professor Abimojin Tunji Ijaya, in honor of his mother. The recipient is Obari Oyinoyi Cristiano, with CDP of 4.73, first class. We have Professor K.R. Onifade's prize for the best graduating student in the Department of Chemical Engineering, and thereby all students of Professor K.R. Onifade. The recipient is Ugozichiku Bright Obochiku, with CGP of 4.81, first class. Also, we have Professor K.R. Onifade's prize for the best graduating student in the School of Engineering and Engineering Technology, endowed by the extended family of Professor K.R. Onifade. And the recipient is Ugozichiku Bright Obochiku, with 4.81 as the CGPA, first class. We also have Professor K.R. Onifade's prize for the best graduating female student in the Department of Chemical Engineering, also endowed by the extended family of Professor K.R. Onifade. and she is Adele Nasifat Adele Mola, with CGPA of 4.04 second class upper. We have also F.A. Gamma's Prize for the best graduating student in the Department of Microbiology, endowed by Professor S.A. Gamma. And the recipient is Ayamole Oluwatobi Abraham, with CGPA of 4.60 first class. Next, we have Professor James Edemudia, the Gallows Prize for the best graduating student in the Department of Estate Management and Evaluation, endowed by Dr. Mohamed Bashir Muru in honor of Professor Egalo. The recipient is Okoro Chinedu Manta, with CGPA of 4.52 first class. Next, we have Madam Victoria Walker's Prize for the best graduating student in the Department of Telecommunication Engineering, endowed by Professor Elizabeth Walker in honor of her mother. And the recipient is Olayemi Olaoluwa Samuel, with CGPA of 4.03 second class upper. Next, we have Chief Charles Adebi's Prize for the best graduating student in evaluation, endowed by Chief Charles Adebi. And this prize is won by Karim Razak, with CGPA of 4.21 second class upper. Next, we have Chief Sanjo's Prize, Chief Sanjo Arabi's Prize for the best graduating student in feasibility and viability studies, endowed by Chief Sanjo Arabi, and is won by Okoro Chinegu Nyanta, with CGPA of 4.52 first class. Also, we have Osita Okoli's Prize for the best graduating student in advanced housing studies, endowed by Osita Okoli. And we have Lasisi Olawale Johnson as the winner, with CGPA of 4.44 second class upper. Next, we have Sir Peter Ojebede's Prize for the best graduating student in the Department of Mathematics, endowed by the family of Professor Hussein Imaku, in honor of their father. And the winner is Tiamil Abdafar Tunde, with CGPA of 4.62 first class. Chancellor, sir, next we move to the school provost. We also have Dr. John Ndamusa Kali's Prize for the best graduating student in analytical chemistry, endowed by Dr. John Danusa Akanya. And the winner is Stevie Oche Michael, with CGPA of 3.87 second class upper. We now move to schools for the Vice Chancellor's Award. School of Agriculture and Agricultural Technology, for the Vice Chancellor's Prize for the best graduating student in the school, we have two candidates: Obari Oyinmiyo Cristiano, 4.73 first class for Animal Production Department. We also have Olaruwa Tunde Sahib, with decent CGPA of 4.73 first class from Department of Soil Science and Land Management. For School of Engineering and Engineering Technology, we have Ugochukwu Bright, Ugochukwu for the Vice Chancellor's Prize for the best of our raw graduating student of the school with 4.81 CGPA first class from the Department of Chemical Engineering. From School of Entrepreneurship and Management Technology, the winner for the Vice Chancellor's Prize for the best graduating student in the school is Osho Moses Ademola with CGPA of 4.62 first class from the Department of Project Management Technology. From School of Environmental Technology, we have Olorun Christian Manjonwano with CGPA of 4.72 first class from the Department of Building Technology for the Vice Chancellor's Prize. In the School of Information and Communication Technology, we have Okeke Joy Chidima for the Vice Chancellor's Prize. She has a CGPA of 4.77 first class from the Department of Computer Science. From the School of Life Sciences, we have Evovan Sarah with 4.76 CGPA first class from the Department of Biochemistry for the Vice Chancellor's Prize for the best overall, for the best graduating student in that school. School of Physical Sciences, we have Alu Sidikatu with CGPA of 4.71 first class from the Department of Geography for the Vice Chancellor's Prize for the best graduating student of School of Physical Sciences. Chancellor Sir, from the School of Science and Technology Education, we have Uwant Daniel Tochi with CGPA of 4.65 first class from the Department of Science Education for the Vice Chancellor's Prize for the best graduating student of the School of Science and Technology Education. Chancellor Sir, we have other awards from organizations. First, we have Osho Moses Ademola with CGPA of 4.62 first class with for the National Identity Card Management Commission's prize for the best graduating student in the Department of Project Management and Technology, endowed by National Identity Card Identity Management Commission. Osho Moses. Okay. For the Friesland Campina Wampo Prize for the best graduating student in the Department of Food Science Technology endowed by Friesland Campina, we have Oche Oyinwochukwu Rachel for the prize. Thank you, sir. Chancellor, sir, I will want to invite the overall best graduating student of this university to make a valedictory address. He is supposed to have been, Ogochukwu Bright Ogochukwu, but he will be represented by OKK Joy Chidima. delivered by Okeke Joy Chidima on the occasion of the 27th Convocation Ceremony and 35th Founders Day of the Federal University of Technology, Minna, on February 1st, 2018. I am highly delighted to address this important gathering of the 27th Convocation Ceremony and the 35th Founders Day of the Federal University of Technology, Minna. I feel highly honored to be given the privilege to speak on behalf of other graduates. I thank the Almighty God for being able to gain admission into the university and for seeing us through the rigors of studies for the past 5 years. Many started and could not finish. Many applied for the admission but did not get it. Though there were some challenges, but thank God today we are celebrating. Federal University of Technology, Minna, I must confess, is a place to be. Having transformed us from naive jam bites in those days to a set of academically and morally equipped graduates. In the course of my studies, I realized that academic success is greatly dependent on determination to achieve what you want to achieve, and that hard work is the path for success. If one is focused and hardworking, success follows. I therefore urge those we are leaving behind to work hard to achieve success. I cannot end this note without commending the management and staff of the great university. The management always puts in place student-centered programs and activities which cater for the interests and needs of every student. Efforts are usually made to ensure that students' welfare on matters such as security, lectures, health, accommodation and transportation are taken into consideration. Therefore, on behalf of my fellow graduates, I doff my cap for the university management for executing programs that restructure our entire well-being to make us part of the allies of this great nation, Nigeria, and for playing a fantastic role which results in reducing cultism, innocent dressing, examination malpractice, among other vices. This university is also blessed with dedicated and experienced lecturers who play their role effectively in ensuring proper instructional delivery and inculcating discipline. Thus, the university is one of the highly esteemed universities of technology in the country. Finally, I urge all the students who are looking forward to a day like this to be dedicated, hardworking, and abide by the rules and regulations of the university to emerge with good results at the end of the program. Thank you very much for your attention.
Chancellor, sir, with your permission, I want to invite the National President of Federal University of Technology, Minna Alumni Association, in the person of Alhaji Ahmed Yahya Hassan, to administer the FUTMINNA pledge.
I invite the graduating students from the various schools and programs of this university to please rise. Please repeat after me. I, your name, Ahmed Yahya Al-Hassan, pledge to defend, protect, and work for the progress of the Federal University of Technology, Minna, by my conduct in all my future endeavors, so help me God. I hereby admit you all and similarly to the FUT Minna Alumni Association. Please be seated. Thank you.
Chancellor, sir, with your permission, I want to invite those institutions that have sent goodwill and congratulatory messages to the 27th convocation of this great university to present their messages. Live University, Abuja. Nigerian Police Academy. Usman Danfodio University, Sokoto. Covenant University. IBB University. Kenya University, Lokoja. University of Maiduguri. Representative of my CVC, Mr. Dugu. Kaduna State University. Federal University, Lafia. Nasarawa State University, Kefi. Salem University, Lokoja. University of Abuja. Modibo Adama University of Technology, Yola. FUT Akure. Federal College of Education, Akoka. Federal College of Education, Technica, Akoka. Federal College of Education, Technology, Lagos, Technica, sorry, Lagos. Niger State Polytechnic, Zungeru. Federal Polytechnic, Bida. University of Port Harcourt, Sokoto State University, University of Ilorin, University, Bukari. Hello, sir. It is my singular privilege and honor to respectfully call upon the visitor to deliver his address to the convocation. The address will be delivered by Professor Shehu Abdullahi, former Vice Chancellor of the great university, the great ABU. Okay, sir. A speech from the Governor of Niger State, and that will be delivered by the Honorable Speaker, Niger State House of Assembly.
I was in billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The visitor of the great university, President Muhammadu Buhari, may now be presented by Professor Abdullahi here this morning. The Chancellor of the Great University, His Royal Highness, Ezedik, you're welcome. The Pro-Chancellor and Chairman of the Governing Council, Professor Femi Adekunle. The Vice-Chancellor of this great university, my President, the Wireless of Sinaja, Professor Bana Abdullahi. All the visiting vice chancellors here, being ably led by Professor Mitrare, you are welcome. The League of the Former Vice Chancellors, ably led by Professor Luzba Wakanji, you are also welcome. Our Royal Fathers here present, ably led by the Emir of Minna, Alhaji Umar Farouk Bahago, you are welcome in your hands. The Security Chiefs here present, you are all welcome to this very wonderful location. Ladies and gentlemen, please permit me to hold on here based on the protocols. Because in a location like this, if I should continue congratulating everyone here, the day will be fast spent. So I want to assure each and everyone here that you are all respectfully invited and you are welcome to this great location. Good afternoon. I'm here to represent His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Niger State, who, not until yesterday, had had it in his schedule to be here present. Because occasions like these are occasions he hates to miss. But because of pressing state matters, he had to travel to Abuja, and painfully, he sent me to be here to be presenting this morning and to deliver his speech. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is the speech of the Governor of Niger State, Alhaji Dr. Abubakar Sani Bello. I feel highly delighted to join you on this 27th convocation ceremony, which also coincides with the 35th Founders Day of this great institution. Let me congratulate the management and staff for achieving this milestone and creating a bold image in the committee of Ivory Towers. To the students of the moment, on behalf of the Niger State Government, I congratulate you for achieving this height in your academic pursuit. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Niger State Government feels very proud to be associated with the Federal University of Technology in Minna. I am indeed delighted to be here because in Niger State, we see all the federal institutions as our own. Hence, we maintain a policy of engaging the institutions. We have since inception been collaborating in various ways of bringing the experience of the gun to the town. We have done this through their research discoveries and other ways. Having said this, the thrust of my golden message as we mark the 37th convocation is to remind us, especially those of us in leadership position, to pay adequate attention to the provision of functional education, which remains the most reliable foundation for sustainable development and societal transformation. As political leaders, nothing apart from security of lives and property should occupy our attention more than education if we must change the narratives of this nation. We must move away from lip service and wishful thinking and take practical steps to reposition the educational sector in this country, not necessarily by setting up too many conflicting and convincing national educational policies which many times compound the problems, but through sound planning and careful implementation of effective stakeholders' engagement in discussing way forward. It is for this purpose that in Niger State, we make education one of our topmost priority. Our transition strategy in the sector is improving the quality and access to every child in the state. We have invested so much in the development of our teachers, hence our existing collaborations with the Cambridge University in the UK and the Ibrahim Badamasi Babangida Universities. We also hope to bring Federal University of Technology Minna in to add value to our technical schools in the state. In conclusion, Let me call on all political leaders to emulate the virtues and values of our founding nationalists, to pay more attention to the educational sector of this nation for the future of the next generations. Once more, I congratulate the Vice Chancellor on his appointment and wish you a successful tenure. Thank you and good afternoon, all of you.
Chief of Defense Staff is here with a good new message. Please can you come forward? Representative of Chief of Defense Staff. To deliver his address. The visitor is ably represented by the former Vice Chancellor of the great university, Amadu-Bello University. He is Professor Sheu Abdullahi.
Excellency, the Executive Governor of Niger State, here ably represented, members of the National Assembly, members of the Imperial Executive Council here present, members of Niger State House of Assembly, members of Niger State Executive Council here present, the Executive Secretary National Universities Commission, the Executive Secretary Ted France, the Chancellor of the University, Your Royal Highnesses, Chairman and members of the Governing Council of this university, members of Senate and entire staff of the university, students, particularly the graduates, parents and guardians, gentlemen of the press, ladies and gentlemen. It is my honor, privilege and pleasure to present the speech of the visitor of this university, His Excellency Muhammad Buhari, GCFR, President, Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the Republic of Nigeria, on the occasion of the 27th Convocation Ceremony at the Federal University of Technology, Minna, held on Thursday, 1st February 2018. The speech goes like this. With gratitude to Almighty God, I'm pleased to address this important gathering on the 25th Founders Day and 27th Convocation Ceremony for the Federal University of Technology, Minna. It is certainly a day of immense joy for this university, parents and guardians, and the graduates, of course. I salute the Governing Council, management and staff of the university for their collective efforts in nurturing of these graduates. I also congratulate the graduating students for their perseverance and steadfastness, which have brought them to the successful completion of their studies. My dear graduates, parents, guardians, I share your joy. I understand that the industry testimony on the performance of graduates of Federal University of Technology, Minna, is positive. In this regard, I commend the management and entire staff of the university for their efforts, just as I salute the alumni and entire students for being a reflection of good education in all areas they found themselves. Certainly, a gathering like this gives us hope that our country is blessed with the vibrancy of educated youth that hold the promise to our country to greater heights. I say this because you youth are the greatest resource of this country. Therefore, do not lose hope, but soldier on in this journey to greatness that I believe you are destined for. Always bear in mind that the certificates you have been awarded today are not mere tickets, but testament to your character and ability to make the society a better place, which we can all be proud of. Let me also remind our youth, particularly the graduates, that in addition to capacity to function in this in industry and create jobs, the education you have acquired has equipped you with the ability to make informed decisions on the various aspects of your personal life and nation building. Being apolitical ultimately does no good, as political leaders make decisions that affect you in many ways. As such, you should be concerned about the character of those who aspire to lead you, just as I urge you to offer yourself to serve where possible. This has become imperative as we mentor those who aspire to succeed us as the leaders for a better Nigeria. As you sojourn into higher levels in life and relate with other compatriots, please think more of the things that unite us as a country than the differences that exist amongst us. This administration is committed to making Nigeria better than we met it. Since we assumed office, we have been working assiduously to ensure a more secure and economically prosperous country. Even though there is still much to be done, our efforts have been yielding fruits. To alleviate the challenge of unemployment, this administration rolled out the Empower Volunteer Scheme, in which 200,000 graduates are employed. Another 300,000 would be engaged in the second phase to bring the total to 500,000. These hundreds of thousands of graduates have been deployed to render various services in different parts of the country and are contributing their quota to the growth of the economy. I assure Nigerians of our commitment to fighting corruption within the ambit of the law, so that our limited resources can be better and more effectively deployed to provide quality education, infrastructure, healthcare, and other amenities for our teeming population. However, we need the support of the youth, the entire student, to succeed. To this end, I implore all students, and most especially the graduates, to rededicate themselves as ambassadors in this moral crusade. The fight against corruption must be won through the participation of all Nigerians. Take advantage of the whistleblowing policy of this administration where you need to in the national interest as your contribution to wipe corruption out of Nigeria. Opportunities abound in agriculture and the small and medium scale businesses which we are supporting and which you can in turn creatively deploy your training from this specialized university to benefit yourself and the society. Let me reiterate that we are committed to building a Nigeria where our able-bodied youth, men and women, will easily find space to utilize their skills and competencies to earn decent living and boost our economy. At this juncture, I salute the vision of my predecessors for establishing and sustaining this specialized university in Nigeria. Our administration recognizes the importance of science and technology education in national development. We are determined to address the challenges facing the education sector despite the constraining factor of limited resources. It was in this direction that we released the sum of 23 billion naira only for the payment of earned allowances to staff of universities. However, I urge all staff unions in our higher institutions to show some understanding in making demands as we make sincere efforts to solving the problems in the education sector. We have always demonstrated our willingness to dialogue just as we have matched our promises with action. As such, we ask the unions to always explore the roundtable option instead of judicial action. I challenge specializing bosses like FUTMINNA to key into our focus on the provision of infrastructure, agricultural and solid mineral development by positioning the relevant programs and faculties in this direction. This is the time to forge the win-win synergy between the universities on one hand and government and industry on the other hand. I also appeal to the private sector to join in striking a stretch and development in these areas. I wish all those who have today been conferred with various degrees and diplomas success in their future endeavors. Once again, I congratulate the graduates, their families, and the entire management and staff of Federal University of Technology, Minna. Long live the Federal University of Technology, Minna. Long live Niger State. Long live Federal Republic of Nigeria. Thank you very much.
Convocation ceremony. We want to inform all the graduates to go to the Cavity Hall, Cavity Lecture Theater, First Bank Lecture Hall, and the classrooms on the first on the ground floor of School of Agriculture and Agricultural Technology for their certificate. Thank you. Chancellor, sir, I have the honor to call upon you to declare the convocation closed.
Thank you.